Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to share this back to school vlog with you all. In this video, I'm taking you along as I get everything ready for the new school year. You'll see some of the shopping I've done for my kids' basic necessities, including shoes, bags, and more. Back to school always feels like a fresh start for me too, so I've been doing some personal planning for my month ahead. I've got a delicious McChicken burger recipe to share, and plus I also did some organizing around the house to keep everything running smoothly once school starts. I hope you enjoy watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Please do stick around till the end and don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you haven't already. Since I was feeling a bit out of sync after the 2 month long summer vacation, I decided to plan for the entire month of September to get back on track regarding my blog and Instagram. So instead of printing out a calendar, I made one by hand, which was so satisfying. I even started a new bullet planner because my previous one pages were over, and so I wanted to make this book look nice and give it a proper bullet journal look. So I thought I'll decorate the first page with some September typography to make it look extra special. I've also been brainstorming video ideas for my YouTube channel, and I'd love to hear your suggestions. Please drop your ideas in the comments below and I'll definitely consider them for my future videos. Last weekend, we headed out to buy all the stuff for school, and I thought I'd share my outfit of the day with you all. I wore this beautiful long dress from the editor's market in Dubai. If you're in Dubai and missing stores like Zara because of the boycott, definitely check out the editor's market, and there's another shop called Lime. They have some amazing minimal dresses and great quality pieces. Along with the dress, I paired a comfy shirt, also from the editor's market, that my sister gifted me. And I've been wearing this dress combination on repeat ever since I got back from Dubai. I also wanted to show you this undercap that I've been loving. I got it from City Center Kuwait, and it's so lightweight and stays perfectly in place. You can find these caps in most of the kiosks inside City Center. Since it was Friday, we went for Jum'ah prayers first and then headed to the Avenue Mall to start our shopping. Once we got there, we met up with our friend and had lunch together at Applebee's. The food was amazing. Everything we ordered was absolutely delicious. After lunch, we started looking for shoes. We wanted to get some really comfy ones because the kids will be wearing them a lot during the long school days and for the whole year. So we ended up getting their shoes from Clarks because they make the comfiest shoes. Then we headed to a stationery shop to pick up some supplies for the kids. I get so excited every time I walk into a stationery store. It makes me feel like a kid again. Next, we went looking for a bag for Hamad as he had his heart set on a specific brand called Herschel. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Unfortunately, we couldn't find it at Avenue, so we decided to leave. We then headed to Brands for Less because I wanted to check something out there. To our surprise, we found the exact Herschel bag that Hamad wanted, and it was even at half price. We were so thrilled and excited, and Hamad finally got his bag. If you're looking for good bags, definitely check out Brands for Less. They have a great collection, including water bottles and more. They even had a cream-colored version of the Herschel bag that Hamad was eyeing. Since Omar is starting school this year, we wanted to get him a lunchbox. As you all know, I'm a big fan of Yumbox lunchboxes. They're really great. I wanted to get the same for Omar, just like Aisha and Hamad had from previous years. They're so durable, long-lasting, and of really good quality. I wanted Omar to choose a color he liked, so I remember that I had bought Hamad's and Aisha's lunchboxes from Scientific Center last year. So we headed there, and although the selection was very small, we were lucky enough to find a green lunchbox, which is Omar's favorite color, so we got that one for him. The next day, I arranged all their bags on a hook. We attached this hook behind the door in the kids' room so they can easily hang up their bags and ID cards when they come back from the school. Here's a look at the inside of Amal's lunchbox. It's so colorful and fun. Aisha got this pencil box and it really reminds me of my own school days. We used to have similar ones back then. It seems like they're back in trend now because I've seen them everywhere in stationery stores. I thought it would be a nice throwback for Aisha, so I decided to get one for her. Then I started labeling all the kids' water bottles and lunch boxes. We got printed labels for each of them, so all I had to do was peel and stick them on. Hamad had been craving a McChicken burger, so I decided to make it at home. It turned out pretty good. To make the patties, I used a mix of chicken breast and thighs, and I added that to a food processor along with black pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, salt, a half a cube of chicken stock, and I processed it until it became a paste like this. I then shaped it into a patty by my hand and I placed it on a lined tray to freeze. I then thought that shaping by hand wasn't perfect, so I used a burger press for the rest, though the patties ended up too big. So I would recommend doing this by hand itself, or if you have a smaller burger press, use it. After freezing so that they firm up, I'll dip it in the batter and fry later. You can freeze them at this stage and finish the cooking in the morning, but it might be a bit hectic. So I prefer to do the frying later once the patties are a bit more solid, and maybe I'll just air fry it in the morning and use it. At the end of every school year, I always clear out this section of the wardrobe where I keep the kids' uniforms and some of their files. But this time, after their school got over, I was pretty lazy to do cleaning of this part of the wardrobe, so that's what I'm doing now. So I sorted through all of last year's uniforms, removed the items they no longer need, and then organized the place with the new uniforms. Once that was done, my next task was to clear out all the old books from this drawer to make space for the new ones. I always feel a bit sad having to throw away so many good textbooks and materials. What do you guys do with the books, with your kids' old books? Do you discard them or give them away? Do let me know. Next, I moved on to making the batter for the McChicken burgers. I mixed all-purpose flour, corn flour, and some seasoning, including black pepper, red chili powder, onion powder, garlic powder, paprika, salt, and baking powder. I mixed it all together and I coated the patties with this dry mixture and placed them on a plate. Since the patties weren't very stiff and didn't freeze well, it was a bit tricky to handle them. It's the best to freeze the patties well to make them easier to work with. I then poured cold water into the remaining flour mixture to make the batter, whisking it until smooth. I then dipped each patty into the batter and fried them on both sides until they were cooked through and crispy. But this part was a little tricky because, as I said, the patty became too big and it was not frozen well. So it was very difficult to handle it. So I just did it somehow and then fried the patty on both sides on medium low flame for about 10 minutes. You don't need to cook this for a long time, otherwise the burger will become very tough. Next, I assembled the burger. The burger bun ended up being quite small compared to the patty, So it was in the most visually appealing one, but it tasted amazing. I used plain mayonnaise, but for a more authentic McChicken sauce, you can mix mayonnaise with mustard and a bit of vinegar. The burger was very crispy and delicious. I fried it for a little over 15 minutes, which made the meat a bit less juicy than I'd like. Next time I'd fry it for a shorter time, but overall it was still really tasty. I finally tackled cleaning the kids' drawing table and pegboard, which was long overdue. I tested all the markers and discarded the ones that weren't working, keeping only the working ones. I also got rid of a lot of non-working pens and other unwanted items. Everything is now back in place, and here's the after look. Please ignore the state of the table itself. The kids tend to draw directly on it rather than on paper, so I've mostly given up on keeping it clean. But it's such a good feeling to have the drawing area decluttered. It was the first day of school and I had some extra patties left. I air fried them to warm them up and make them crispy again, but they definitely wouldn't stay crispy in the lunchbox. The kids decided they didn't want them as burgers, so I cut them into pieces and gave them as nuggets. I also packed banana chips, grapes, and some sweet corn mixed with red chili powder, lemon, black pepper, butter, and salt. Alhamdulillah, we are grateful that we can send our kids to school with all the necessary support and security. At the same time, my heart feels very heavy thinking about the children in Palestine who are unable to start school and the many mothers who have lost their children and are missing them dearly. On this day, let's encourage our kids to pray for the children in Palestine and keep them in their thoughts. I got these stamps for labeling the kids' uniforms, but unfortunately, the quality isn't great. After just one day of wear, the ink started to fade due to sweat. Since it was the first day of school, the kids woke up happily and didn't make much fuss. This was the hairstyle I did for Aisha on her first day. If you're interested, I could make a full video on different hairstyles for girls. Just let me know in the comments. I'll definitely post it in the coming days. That's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please share it with your family and friends. Until next time, bye, and thank you so much for watching.